a while from now. If I'm not feeling any less sour, I promised myself to treat myself and visit a nearby tower. And climbing to the top, I threw myself off in an effort to make it clear to whoever what it's like when shelterless, standing in the lurch at the church where people saying, "My God, that's tough." She stood him up. No point in us remaining. We may as well go home, as I did it on my own, alone again, naturally. Think that only yesterday I was cheerful, bright and gay, looking forward to, but who unto the hole I was about to play. But as if to knock me down, reality came around, and without so much as a mere touch could mean to little pieces, leaving me to doubt. Talk about God and His mercy, for if He really does exist, why He did desert me in my hour of need. I truly am indeed alone again, naturally. It seems to me there are more hearts broken in the world that can't be mended, left unattended. What do we do? What do we do? Now looking back over the years, and whatever else that appears, I remember that I cried when my father died, never wishing to hide the tears. At 65 years old, my mother, God rest her soul, couldn't understand why the only man she had ever loved had been taken, leaving her to start with a heart so badly broken. Despite encouragement from me, no words were ever spoken. When she passed away, I cried and cried, oh dear.